First bit of news is out of the USA. A lot of things that I'm going to be saying here, I'm scared we're going to get flagged on YouTube for something because there's been some really terrible news
Don't say the D word. Just be like, you know, just D word and then continue. Because YouTube doesn't understand. YouTube is, you know, stupid. It doesn't understand that we're not saying it. We're just reading the news. All right, go ahead.
Okay. The only good Muslim is a DEAD one. Rashida Tlaib tears up while reading death threat. During a House hearing on domestic terrorism, Representative Rashida Tlaib got emotional as she read one of the death threats she had received during her short tenure in Congress. She read a threat she received shortly after the mass shootings at mosques in New Zealand. "I was totally excited and pleased when I heard about 49 Muslims that were killed and many more wounded in New Zealand. Let's hope and pray it continues here in the good old USA. The only good Muslim is a one." So she asked the FBI Assistant Director of Counterterrorism, Michael McGarrity, to show how is this not enough to fall under domestic terrorism if they're targeting her solely based on her faith, and others saying that, you know, a good Muslim is one that's no longer with us. McGarrity in the FBI does not differentiate between domestic terror threats and foreign terror threats, and they take them very seriously. So, yeah, I mean, these threats should be taken seriously, even though, you know, someone's just saying, even if someone's not coming out directly and saying, like, you need to die because, or you are going to because, all these threats need to be taken seriously. And it needs to be taken seriously against anyone who's being targeted for their race, religion, whatever, including atheists. I can't tell you how many times Armin or myself or just Atheist Republic inbox alone receives death threats and stuff. This is ridiculous. If you don't like somebody for what they have to say, you know, you don't have to listen, but to wish them to be dead or killed. I mean, this is outrageous.
I mean, duh, right?
that needs to go without saying.
Yeah,
but we live in a world where it doesn't.
What I'm wondering is that once we scroll down, how many comments we're going to get that supports these hateful comments. I'm hoping it's going to be less than before. Sometimes there's a, you know, it's high, sometimes, you know, we get different results, but we'll scroll down and see what the top comments are. But what I'm wondering is her question. So obviously, I mean, you know, it's really sad, you know, sad to have to go through this. You know, people don't understand that even if you have a lot of experience getting a lot of hateful comments, when you read it out loud to somebody, all of a sudden it gets to you. Because it's really, really difficult when people hate you this much. And many people don't have experience with this. But sometimes you just read, a lot of times you think like, you know what, I'm stronger than this. I'm used to this. I've read it. I've said that to myself. Like, you know, nobody could hurt me anymore because I've heard it all. Like, so many people have wished me dead, have wished to come and rape my wife. They told me that they're going to come find us, kill us. And at some point, you're going to be like, you know what? These are just words. They can't hurt me anymore. But then sometimes then you read it again and again and again, and you're like, how could people hate me so much? You know, what did I ever fucking, what did I do to them? And you just wonder, like, how could there be this much hate? Like, what the hell is wrong with people? And it just gets to you. And sometimes you just discover that it still hurts you, even though you thought that you're stronger than this, it still hurts you, right? So I get it. I get that she, like, all of a sudden started crying. I don't think she was planning. Like, I watched the video. It just came, like, without her expecting it, right? But what I'm wondering is, when she says, how is this not terrorism? Like, who is she talking to? She's talking to an FBI representative or something? Because to me...
Yeah, Michael McGarrity.
Yeah, but did anybody suggest that this is not... like domestic terrorism? Like, what is she responding to? Did the FBI say, oh, we're not going to take death threats to Muslims seriously? Well, why is she acting like the FBI does take this very seriously. I don't understand what the accusation here is.
I'm not sure either. She wanted to know why it wasn't enough to fall under domestic terrorism, because they're targeting her solely based on her faith. And, you know, they clearly did come from the USA, because part of it was, let's hope and pray this continues here in the good old USA.
But if it does take this seriously, I don't understand.
Right, and that's what McGarrity came back and said. He said that we don't even differentiate between domestic terror threats or foreign terror threats. Like, a terror threat is a terror threat. We take them all very seriously. Now, I think that there'd be maybe a difference between somebody... I don't even know. I mean, clearly this would be a threat that anyone would take seriously. We've reported comments to the FBI that they've taken very seriously.
Yeah, they take it very seriously. I don't understand. Like, I sympathize with her, and I sympathize with the fact that she has to deal with a lot of nasty comments that nobody should have to deal with. But I also wonder, why is she making an accusation to FBI for not taking death threats like this seriously? Because they definitely do. They definitely do. FBI takes these kind of threats seriously. So, I mean, I'm very grateful for, you know, even though I actually don't live in the USA, but I'm grateful for these kind of officials that do look into this. Like, they make United States or Canada, where I am, much safer than most other countries. So I don't understand. I mean, I think we should be grateful. So I really don't understand what her accusation here is. Maybe there's something that we don't understand. But let me see what the top comments are. Let's hope, Ellie, let's hope the top comments are not that bad. Let's see. Okay, top number one comment. The top comment with 470 reactions. Oh, wow. For those that find this funny, you're what's wrong with the world today. Okay, so good. The top comment is actually against the hateful comments. That's good. Next top comment, Joyce is saying, wow, some of you folks, I'm an atheist, not a douchebag. Too bad. More of you can't say the same. Okay, so good. The second top comment is also calling out people. So first, it's encouraging that this is the second top comment, but it's also a little bit discouraging because that means that there are a lot of comments that is actually making fun of this. Let me actually find this. Abraham is saying the crocodile tears. Her beliefs are clear that everyone who don't believe in them easily should be killed. So playing the victim can only be accepted by her kind. By her kind and the fools. Okay. So Abraham is saying because she's a Muslim, wow, okay, because she's a Muslim, these are crocodile tears, and that everyone who don't believe in, and if you believe her, you're a fool as well, and that because she's a Muslim, she must think that everybody that doesn't believe in their Islam should be killed. Oof, I don't even know how to start. Okay, first of all, let's make this one something clear, because a lot of people come here and we speak against people like Abraham, and people think that we're Islam apologists. Islam as a religion is backward, barbaric, nonsense, crazy shit that needs to end, okay? However, for you to generalize all Muslims as if most Muslims, this is my line that I always use, most Muslims are better than Islam. And for you to think most, you know, you could make a judgment call on an individual just because she, you know, thinks that she follows a religion that she doesn't. You know, it's very simple. The example I give to people that don't have experience with Muslims and, you know, don't even try to understand them, they just overgeneralize and do want collective punishment and try to, you know, think they can make it statement like this about an entire group of people is to think about Christians, because Christians, how many Christians, Ellie, have you met? Because I've been around Muslims most of my life, right? But you've been around Christians most of your life, right?
Right.
Do you agree that most Christians don't think that women should not have a position of authority? That most Christians agree that women should be able to have a position of authority?
Outside of the church, yes.
Right.
I would agree that many do. I've been involved in places like Church of Christ where women shouldn't even pray if there's a man available to do it for them.
But that's not what I'm saying, because yes, I know you can find examples of Christians that think that women should not have
a
position.
It's not an example. It's like in their belief system. But if you're talking about Christians in general and yes. women outside of the church having positions of authority, I would say that the majority of the Christians I've met in my life do agree that women can be in positions of authority.
Of authority. Most Christians in the world think that women can be in a position of authority. Agree? What does the Bible say, though? The Bible says that they shouldn't, right?
Right.
So it's very simple, people. The Bible says that women shouldn't be in a position of authority, yet most Christians think that women can be in a position of authority. You could be like, well, they're not following religion. Yeah, they're not. They're not. It's a good thing that they're not. It's the same thing with Muslims. Most Muslims, Islam, the Quran, okay? The Quran is barbaric, it's violent, it's anti-woman, it's anti-science, it's anti-most values that makes this world a better place. But most Muslims are not violent. Most Muslims are kind people. Most Muslims are better than the Quran. Okay? It's very simple. And you might say like, oh, well, then they're not true Muslims. No, they are true Muslims because the definition of a Muslim is not somebody that follows Islam 100%. Okay? The definition of Muslim is somebody that believes in Allah and the Quran and Muhammad. We're like, well, how could somebody believe in the Quran and not follow it word by word? Well, yeah, that's a question that I ask myself as well. But that's just the reality. People think that the Quran is the direct word of God, and they haven't even read it. They haven't even bothered to read it cover to cover. So how is that logical? Well, it's not, but that's the reality, okay? Most Muslims, the things that they do, the values that they have, is better than Islam. So don't, just because Islam teaches you something barbaric and violent, don't go and say, well, then every freaking Muslim is barbaric and violent. It doesn't work like that. And I think people know that it doesn't work like that. These are just hateful people that want excuses to hate other people. These are people that are as hateful or somewhat hateful, or like, you know, just like the Quran is hateful. These people like Ibrahim are hateful, all right? I'd take the side of a kind Muslim than an asshole atheist any day, okay? Because, yes, the Muslim could be wrong. The Muslim is wrong about Islam. The Muslim is wrong about what reality is like. The Muslim is wrong about God. The Muslim is wrong about many things. But I'll take the wrong Muslim that values other people's happiness and is not a dick, is not an asshole to their fellow human beings. I'll take that wrong Muslim over the person that I agree with, over the existence of God, over the nature of Islam, but is an asshole and can't sympathize with somebody that is getting death threats, I'll take the Muslim over this atheist. Leo is saying, I hate the religion, love the people. If you're laughing at this, what is wrong with the world? I'm not going to be very nitpicky with Leo. Don't say love the people, because if you just say love everybody, then you're just devaluing love. Just judge people individually, okay? Jake is saying, for a follower of a religion that calls for the death of non-believers in the first few pages, her reading death threats yields no sympathy for me. Well, Jake, your logic is self-contradictory, because then if based on your logic, if you don't have sympathy for other people, then nobody should have sympathy for you either, if not whatever happens to you. Like, you just, now this kind of thinking is just going to go, you know, circle of hate. You just bring on, you know, everybody's gonna end up hating everybody if you keep thinking like that. And again, people, you have to understand the difference between people that are unknowingly supporting a religion that endorses hate and the people that are knowingly endorsing hate. Yes, good intentions doesn't always end in good results. Good intentions could end up in horrible results. But if people have good intentions, the way you tackle that is different with people that have bad intentions. I'm not saying people's good intentions is an excuse for us not to attack their ideas. No, we'll still attack their ideas. But you don't personally attack people that have good intentions. Even if their good intentions still end up in dangerous results, the way you tackle that is by befriending them. Anyways, I've been repeating myself so many times on this. Let me see what the live chat has to say.
Oh, yeah, let's look at what Tina R. has to say in our live chat, because she brings up a very good point about what constitutes the difference between a terroristic threat and freedom of speech. You can wish that somebody is dead all you want, and that's not a terroristic threat. When the United States draws a line over terroristic threat is when you threaten to kill somebody. And this phrase, like Tina R. said in our live chat, no one here is actually threatening to do her any harm. They're just wishing, you know, wishing harm. And that there's the difference.
Right. So actually, thank you so much for bringing that up. So
Thank you, Tina.
So it's important. So Rashida is wrong here. I think based on what you're saying, even though we sympathize with her, and the fact that she's getting these death threats are horrible, she shouldn't try to use this and to try, like, because the FBI is just being consistent, right? Like, they're not, if they're saying this is not terrorism, they don't have a double standard. They're not saying, oh, because you're a Muslim and because these are white people, that's why it's not a death. Like, and to suggest that is such a dessert, you know, it's being ungrateful to the FBI. If a Muslim also comes and says, oh, I wish somebody kills Armin. Okay? That's not terrorism. That's horrible. You could call it out. I mean, people have. Okay, right. So I had the police come to my apartment because of the threats that I got, right? And a lot of people have wished me harm. But the only reason why they ended up coming was, like, I have hundreds of people, like, I hope I see you die a painful death. I hope somebody comes and rapes your wife. I hope somebody does. Like, these are, none of that was taken seriously. Until somebody says, where is this event? We should go bomb it. That's the only time that the police took it seriously. So, the authorities are, they're consistent. Just because people are wishing me harm, then, you know, even if it doesn't matter if it's a white supremacist or a Muslim, if they're wishing me harm, that's not terrorism. If somebody says, like, hey, let's plan something and go do something horrible to this person, then now they're going to pay attention. Okay? So, Rashida, while we sympathize with you, while we think it's horrible that people are giving you death threats, you shouldn't be using this as a way to suggest that the FBI has a bias. You shouldn't be using this as a way to suggest that FBI will only take terrorist threats seriously if it's by Muslims against other people. In fact, some people argue otherwise. Some people argue that they are paying more attention to that than Islamic terrorist threats.
The FBI director did go on to tell her that if she believed another statute was needed, to please come speak to the Department of Justice.
Right.
And so, I mean, that's just like you were saying earlier, it's keeping it fair to everyone. Keeping it consistent.
Yeah. So, again, the FBI is like, hey, listen, we don't make the laws. We're just following, we're just executing the laws, okay? If you think this is not fair, then you're the lawmaker here, right? Isn't she the lawmaker?
Like, yes, at this time, yes.
so change the laws. Like, I don't, like, what do you want us to do? Yeah, again, by the way, it's like us criticizing Rashida doesn't mean that we are endorsed. Like, we still you could sympathize with her getting death threats and also criticize her here at the same time, right? I think it's unfair that she's getting death threats, but I think her the way she's, you know, criticizing the FBI is also unfair on her part. And I think that she should know that. And it actually scares me that she doesn't know that. Like, that she's trying to... I think she might... she shouldn't be using this... The fact that she is a victim. Okay? She is a victim here. But she shouldn't be using this to try to make an argument that doesn't make any logical sense here. So we can sympathize with her and call her out on this bullshit at the same time, I think.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we are doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي podcast باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.